भारत माता की। नाउ मे आई रिक्वेस्ट प्रिंसिपल सर टू रीड आउट भारत का संविधान के उद्देशिका। सो आई रिक्वेस्ट सर टू रीड आउट द प्रीएम्बल ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन।
भारत को एक संपूर्ण प्रभुत्व संपन्न समाजवादी धर्मनिरपेक्ष लोकतांत्रिक गणराज्य बनाने के लिए तथा उसके समस्त नागरिकों को सामाजिक आर्थिक और राजनीतिक न्याय विचार अभिव्यक्ति विश्वास धर्म और उपासना की स्वतंत्रता प्रतिष्ठा और अवसर की क्षमता प्राप्त कराने के लिए तथा उन सब में व्यक्ति की गरिमा और राष्ट्र की एकता और अखंडता सुनिश्चित करने वाली बंधुता बढ़ाने के लिए दृढ़ संकल्प होकर इस संविधान को अंगीकृत अधिनियमित और आत्मार्पित करते हैं।
अब सर से आग्रह है कि सर अपना उद्बोधन दें गणतंत्र दिवस के इस सुबह में। सर से रिक्वेस्ट है प्रिंसिपल सर से दैट प्लीज एड्रेस अस ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ 72nd रिपब्लिक डे सेलिब्रेशन। प्रिंसिपल सर।
ऑल माय एस्टीम्ड कलीग्स फ्रॉम रीजनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड डीएम स्कूल भोपाल एंड माय कलीग्स फ्रॉम पीएसएससीआईवी भोपाल, डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ आरआई भोपाल एंड डीएमएस भोपाल, अलुमनाई एंड फॉर्मर स्टूडेंट, फॉर्मर एम्प्लॉईज ऑफ द कैंपस, गेस्ट्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विश टू विश यू ए वेरी हैप्पी रिपब्लिक डे 2021। द कंट्री इज टुडे सेलिब्रेटिंग 72nd रिपब्लिक डे टू कमेमोरेट द डे ऑन व्हिच आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन केम इनटू फोर्स as adopted. And as you all know that it is on this day in the year 1950 that we got Purna Swaraj. On Independence Day, that is on 1947 August 15, we got Swaraj, free from the subjugation of British Raj. But we got Purna Swaraj on this day when we got a written constitution, which is the most prestigious constitution of the world, the longest constitution having 395 articles, and it is under the leadership of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar that this constitution was created and ultimately came into force. And this constitution is a very prestigious a kind of document that guides the entire activities of the nation, whether economy, whether education, whether health, or any other thing. It guides all the policies of the country. And this constitution has given us fundamental rights. There are the three characteristics, most important characteristics of this constitution, that it makes India a federal nation, and it provided a list of fundamental rights, which is the essence of freedom, and declared India as a parliamentary form of government. So we have freedom of education, freedom of speech, right to equality, right against exploitation, and all kinds of rights it has given to the citizens of India. So here, as you all know, that since last 9 months, we are passing through a very critical stage, that is COVID pandemic. And in these 9 months, we have celebrated our Independence Day. And in this situation also, we are celebrating our Republic Day. And today, in both these occasions in the history, that students are not participating in the celebration. So in this context, I would like to bring some of the issues that are associated with the education system and also our economy that indirectly affects our education system. You must be aware that 320 million means 32 crore children of our country are adversely affected by this pandemic situation, and our education system is facing a new crisis. So what are the crises? They're like loss of human capital and economic opportunities, diminished economic opportunity. And mostly poor countries are affected by this. We are talking of digital divide. Because we are talking of digital learning, online learning, and we are already experiencing digital divide. So similarly, now this digital divide is also affecting our educational divide. As we know, almost half of the children of the world are there in India that are affected by this pandemic situation, because India is the largest democracy, is the largest, having the largest education system next to China, and it has created educational inequalities. When we are talking of digital divide, it also has led to educational inequalities. And already our national education policy document says that 3.2 million children, means 20 lakh children, they are now already out of school. Now this situation has made many such children out of school. But in order to face this challenge, India has brought digital revolution, and in the pandemic period only, that PM, Digital India campaign on PM EBITDA was launched by ministry under digital revolution. But that has not solved our problem. Under Digital India movement or revolution, we have PM EBITDA, as I said, and so many initiatives were taken to which India is a part. You must be all knowing that we have one Diksha portal or Diksha platform, that is called One Channel, One Country, in which we are providing एनी टाइम एनी वेयर एजुकेशन टू स्टूडेंट्स एंड टीचर्स ऑफ दिस कंट्री. इन एडिशन टू दीक्षा वी हैव ऑल्सो स्वयंप्रभा टीवी चैनल दैट जो वन क्लास वन चैनल देर आर 12 चैनल्स क्लासेस 1 to 12 एंड आवर आर आई भोपाल हैज सिग्निफिकेंट कंट्रीब्यूशन टू दिस चैनल टू ब्रिंगिंग टू टेक द एजुकेशन टू द डोर स्टेप ऑफ द चिल्ड्रेन. मेनी ऑफ आवर फैकल्टी मेंबर्स स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम अरुणाब सौरभ पुई डॉक्टर पुई डॉक्टर रश्मि सिंघाई डॉक्टर चित्रा सिंह डॉक्टर सारिका साजू डॉक्टर कल्पना मस्की डॉक्टर एल एस चौहान डॉक्टर संजय पंडागले प्रोफेसर रत्नमाला आर्य डॉक्टर सारिका एंड मेनी अदर्स प्रेजेंट हियर एंड मेनी ऑफ आवर स्कूल टीचर्स ऑल्सो दे हैव कंट्रीब्यूटेड टू दिस स्वयंप्रभा चैनल टीवी चैनल एंड वी हैव दैट वे सर्व द कंट्री इन टेकिंग एजुकेशन टू द चिल्ड्रेन इन दिस पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन. देन कमिंग टू स्वयं सो दैट इज ए मूक ऑनलाइन मूक प्लेटफॉर्म एंड यू विल बी हैप्पी दैट ऑल्सो वी हैव विथ अस डॉक्टर गंगा महतो. ही हैज डेवलप्ड मूक फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन रीजनल इंस्टीट्यूट्स ऑफ एजुकेशन फॉर क्लास 11 स्टूडेंट्स ए मूक ऑनलाइन प्रोग्राम इन इंग्लिश and very soon it is going to be placed in CIET channel so that not only the students of class 11 students of DM school but also the entire country, even those who are not studying in school, they will be benefited. This way, this is our contribution. Then All India Radio, like community radio, and Shikshavani brought out by CBSE. So there are many such initiatives taken by the ministry to which our NCERT has played an important role. As I have already said, that not only our education is directly affected by this pandemic, our economy also has directly been affected, and indirectly it has affected the system of education. Today, in this situation, 30 lakh workers of they are working on unorganized sectors are severely affected. We are all working in organized sector, government sector. We are getting our pay, we are getting our DA as usual. But the workers that particularly migrant workers, they are severely affected, and their number is 14 lakh. And in our country, only 10% of the people are working in organized sector. 10% of the population, and 95% of the population, they are engaged in unorganized sectors. And it has affected our education of our children. If the economy is affected, ultimately education will be affected. And if you see the economic policy or industrial policy of our country, or for that matter any country, they talk of hyper digitalization. When we are talking of industrial revolution or economic revolution, evolution of economic policies, new economic policies, more importance is given on digitalization, or you can say in industry hyper digitalization. And that is what is called at home technology. Now work from home, that is a new terminology that has come. Similarly, our economic policies and industrial policies also talk of work home technologies. But these policies have not addressed to the educational inequalities. Maybe in economy we have improved, in industry sector we have improved, but that has not positively affected our education system. It has rather created digital divide. So under this situation, we have many other also issues related to online or digital education. Like, we have a multilingual country having large number of hundreds of languages in the country. The country is, you can say, like our we know all mostly South Korea. Many of our teachers, they know about South Korea. That's only one language. They don't have any problem. We have one digital platform for one country, but we have many languages. And our digital e-learning digital platform has not able to manage the various dialects and various languages of the country and various experiences of the country. And we are now talking of new normal, e-learning as a new normal. If you have, but this e-learning has not able to address the issue of equity and quality. Equity has affected, and the quality of education also has been affected. So what are the issue? It is said that 36% of the schools have no electricity. We are talking of digital or online education. The recent data say that 36% of our schools do not have electricity. And 53% of households receive less than 12 hours of electricity. When we are talking of online education, electricity is an issue. And another thing, that in our rural area, only 15% of the households, they have internet connectivity. And in urban area, the percentage is 42%. This is the NSS data, 1917-18. So if this is the situation of electricity supply and internet connectivity in rural and urban areas, then online education must create a digital divide. It means it cannot reach beyond 15% of the population or households in a rural area. And let me tell you, compare with the, again, South Korea, Republic of South Korea. Our many teachers have attended one consultancy session, particularly more number of teachers of DM school that provided by Krivet Korea. And they said 99% of the households, they have internet connectivity. If we take together urban and rural area, it will, in India, it will not exceed 25%. It will not exceed 25% or hardly 30%. If it is 15% in urban area, the rural area, and 42% in urban area, then the percentage maximum will go 30%. You see, they have internet connectivity, and also our digital access to digital device. So India, although is a developing country, the developing countries and underdeveloping countries are seriously affected by or adversely affected by this digitalization. Now, I will be also telling some of the ethical issues, associated with this online learning or digital learning. We are now practicing remote learning technology. When I say remote learning, then it is other than face-to-face learning, mostly technology driven. And mostly, when we are talking of remote learning facilities, that is usually done in pandemic situation or emergency situation. And this is different from virtual classroom or virtual education. Virtual education is systematic. It was prior to also this pandemic situation, virtual learning or virtual classroom. When you talk of virtual classroom, it has a systematic structure, a systematic curriculum. But now we do not have curriculum for this emergency situation across the country. And of course, NCERT has brought many guidelines, like you have Pragyata guidelines for online education, like alternative academic calendar, student enhancement learning guidelines, counseling services, for school students. Dr. Saurabh Kumar, he is a part of this counseling services for school students for the north, for this our region, and cyber safety and security guidelines, e-content version 2 guidelines for development of e-contents, and online NISTA guideline or online NISTA program. These are many initiatives brought out by ministry through NCERT. But the ethical misconduct as a result of this online learning is increasing day by day. So what are the ethical misconduct? We are also part of it, both students and teachers. Let me tell you some of the ethical misconduct. Cyber bullying. The degree of cyber bullying has increased. Cyber bullying means sending bad messages, unethical messages, unethical pictures through online mode. And the students are doing that. Sometimes teachers are also doing that knowingly or unknowingly. And our students and teachers should know that this is punishable under IT Act 2000, IT Act 2000, and also Indian Penal Code. They are punishable. Then paid writing assistant during examination. When we are now many universities, many boards, they have adopted online examination. Sometimes our students or even parents, they appoint paid writers. They give money and they sit in the examination. Then providing user ID and password to others. Students give user ID and password to others. The others do some harm also. And they participate in online discussion forum. Online test, correct, many students find the correct answers from the internet. When online examination is going on, we are not sure that this is the performance of our students. They might have collected it from internet. Then asking others to sit in the examination, online examination. And in case of teachers, it is infringement of copyright. When we are talking of internet-based learning, internet-based education, it is seen that many teachers are copying. You may say that there is no copyright in this document or in this material. But any educational material created by, although it is not mentioned, is at the time of creation already copyrighted. So we are not expected to reproduce them in the name that there is no copyright. So there are many issues associated with this online education that we call new normal. But this new normal is not really new normal, what I feel. And what is our task? If we, in case we switch over to online education in future, in a larger scale, then our policies, our education policy and economic policy must address digital divide. Unless and until we address a digital divide and this connectivity, access to internet, access to electricity, then online education cannot be considered as new normal. And we cannot achieve the sustainable development goal, that is goal 4, which talks of ensure inclusive, equitable and quality education and promote lifelong learning opportunities for all. This is not possible. And our education system, our school education system or higher education system is related to attainment of this goal 4. I again repeat, our goal, sustainable development goal 4, to which India is a signatory, talks about inclusive, equitable, quality education and promote lifelong learning opportunities for all. When we say equitable education, then we have to provide education, more facilities to disadvantaged sections of the society. Otherwise, education cannot be equitable. I am not telling about equal opportunity, rather equitable opportunity. And that speaks of our target must be the socially and educationally disadvantaged group of the society, to about which there are six types of disadvantaged sections of the society, which our national education policy talks of. So, with this, I thank you all for listening to what I wanted to communicate in this situation and on this day. And I also request that this should be also, these messages that you have already with us should be transmitted, should be brought to the students' notice that IT, particularly, I'm again emphasizing on the cyber bullying or ethical misconduct that is happening as a result of this online or digital learning. With this, I once again wish you a very happy Republic Day. Jai Hind.
धन्यवाद सर. जैसा कि सर ने भी कहा, ऐसे में भी इस पेंडेमिक सिचुएशन में, जहां COVID-19 की आतंक दिमागों में है, उसके बाद भी हम आज अपने 72वें गणतंत्र दिवस को मनाने के लिए पूरे जोश के साथ एकत्रित हुए हैं. तो मैं यही कहना चाहूँगी, हवा चाहे तो आतंक मचा ले, हम वो चिराग हैं जो आंधियों में भी जलते हैं. ये सब हमारे प्राचार्य प्रोफेसर नित्यानंद प्रधान सर की प्रेरणा से ही सब संभव हो पाया है. सर, आपके नेतृत्व में RIE भोपाल ने COVID-19 की सिचुएशन में भी निरंतर नए आयाम छुए हैं और लोगों की भरपूर सहायता की है, चाहे वो रूरल रहा हो या अर्बन एरिया. अंत में मैं सर का कुछ शब्दों के साथ धन्यवाद करना चाहूँगी. कहाँ हैं ऐसे लोग जो निष्प्रह रण में जूझते जाते हैं? कहाँ हैं ऐसे लोग जो निष्प्रह रण में जूझते जाते हैं, पर हित में निज हेतु त्याग कर प्यार बांटते जाते हैं? पर हित में निज हेतु त्याग कर प्यार बांटते जाते हैं. आशाओं के पुष्प पल्लवित होते हैं इन्हीं मालियों से. आशाओं के पुष्प पल्लवित होते हैं इन्हीं मालियों से. आओ इनका धन्यवाद कर हम अपना जीवन सफल बनाते हैं. धन्यवाद सर.
थैंक यू वेरी मच. नाउ आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट प्रिंसिपल सर टू बी ऑन द स्टेज ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ 72nd Republic Day celebration. At the address of Government of India, we organized essay writing competition and poetry recitation competition for the students of DMS. And I'd like to request the HM DMS sir to come, Harish Prasad sir, to come on the stage. The topics for the essays and receive the prize for the students and distribute the same. I request also Dean of Instruction Kakariya sir to come on the stage. The topics for the essays were Indian Constitution, Our Struggle for Freedom, Warriors of Indian Independence, and Knowledge, Tradition, Practices, and Heritage of India. The competition was organized online, and on this, I request the winners. Nisha Malviya of class 12A got the first position. Please clap for her. Amber Jain of class 12C got second position. And Bhavna Gupta of class 11A got the second position. And Anushka Ashivar of class 9B got the consolation prize. So I request Principal sir to give the prize to Harish Prasad sir. And sir in turn will give away the prizes to the students. These are just selected few prizes. The remaining prizes are there in a box which Harish sir will give to the students. On the same occasion of 72nd Republic Day, we have poetry recitation competition on the topic Bharat Ke Swatantrata Senani, and it was also organized online. And in this competition, आई वुड लाइक टू अनाउंस द रिजल्ट एंड आई रिक्वेस्ट प्रिंसिपल सर ऑल्सो टू गिव द ओके आई रिक्वेस्ट द विनर्स सिद्धि थापा ऑफ सेवेंथ वी गॉट फर्स्ट पोजिशन शिवम भागले ऑफ एट वी गॉट सेकेंड पोजिशन एंड तन्वी श्रीवास्तव ऑफ सिक्स ए गॉट थर्ड पोजिशन एंड वी हैव Horian Khan of class 6, they got consolation prize. Thanks to all the winners. Congratulations to all the winners. And thank you, Principal Sir, Dean of Instruction Sir, and Chief Advisor Students Council Ma'am.
Yes, the wind was a little bit colder, and we're all getting older, and the clouds are moving on with every autumn breeze. Bitter punches we came fertilizer. एक कटोरी भर कर गोरी धूप हमें भी लाना जी सूरज जल्दी आना जी जब कर बैठे आवाज आर पार ना दिखता है
सो विद दिस वी हैव कम टू द एंड ऑफ 72nd रिपब्लिक डे सेलिब्रेशन